I had waited a long time for this day. I know it sounds kind of cliche, but what I mean by that is, like, not specifically just marrying Andy or whatever, but I never thought I'd actually get married, because I never thought I'd actually find somebody that would, for one, put up with me, but also, you know, I feel like I could put up with her, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, shock hasn't hit me yet. I feel like it'll probably hit me when we actually walk out there and start the whole thing, so. Have much else to say.
My dearest love, today is the day we have waited for so long. I'm so thankful for our relationship and the joy it brings to me. You are such a blessing, and I can't imagine my life without you in it. You are the most important person in my life and one of the very best things to happen to me. I feel so loved and safe when I'm with you. You make me feel so beautiful. The way you love me brings such a fullness and joy to my life. You bring out the best in me, and you are truly my better half. I am so proud of everything we have accomplished in the past 3.5 years. You are such a good and hardworking man. I am so, so thankful the Lord has paired us together. I could have never in my wildest dreams come up with a man as perfect for me as you. I love you so much. I am so excited to marry you, and I cannot wait to see you at the altar. Love, Andrea.
All right, well, like I said, I don't want to keep crying, but let's get it on.
Need to ask the question today. Who giveth this woman to be married to this man?
Well, I reckon her mother and I.
my privilege and honor today as your pastor to pronounce you husband and wife in the name of Jesus Christ, who will journey with you into your future. Nathaniel, you may kiss your wife, and Andrea, you may kiss your husband. The first kiss in that journey. All right, now say it later. Nathaniel and Andrea, you are no longer two independent persons, but one. And what therefore God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Ladies and gentlemen, I present unto you Mr. Nathaniel and Mrs. Andrea Donaldson. For it's your poor.
Just a little minute. I got a little story I want to tell. And I have, all the people I've told this to is my wife, and I told Greg. I hadn't, so Nathaniel and Andy, I'm not aware of it either, but Nathaniel graduated from high school. He was working and all busy, so I went out to the health unit to get his shot records and all so he could get enrolled over at Delta, when you had to have all that. So I went in there, and I didn't know Andy from nobody, but she was working in there. So she helped me with all that stuff, you know, and I had to go back a couple of times. And I went home, and I told Vicki, I said, there's the sweetest little old girl out there working at the health unit. I don't know who she is, but, you know, I said, I'd like to try to get her and Nathaniel together. And, I know you didn't know it. The reason I hadn't told it, because I didn't want, you know, that to influence anything that they did. So, I'm telling it after
you
fact.
Tell it.
It wasn't just a few months after that, they showed up at church.
Now, oh my.
Y'all, and then they kind of started getting together, and there's a little story to that too. So me and Greg had a little talk. They first started dating, and I told Greg what I just told y'all. I said, I hadn't told them, and I ain't gonna tell them. He said, oh, no. But right before Nathaniel and Andy got together, Nathaniel was fishing. He's making a decision. He said he'd go down a wrong road. And I told him, I said, you don't need to do this. Well, that night, Brother Stroud said something that was kind of, Brother Stroud didn't know what he was saying, but it was a warning to Nathaniel. Nathaniel come home. I said, well, did you hear what Brother Stroud said? Roadblock. That's God putting a roadblock in your path. You ignore it. I said, that's all right. It wasn't long, there was something else that happened. I said, that's a roadblock. God's telling you something, Nathaniel. And at this time, I didn't know all that he was going to do. He didn't tell me that, and in fact, everything that was involved in his decision. I said, you keep it knowing the roadblocks, that God's going to stop you. Yeah. And the day, two or three days before he was fixing to launch out on this new adventure, the Lord caused him to fall and break his hand. And he broke the only bone in that hand. That doctor said that's the worst bone you can break. They can't operate on it. They can't do a thing to it. And there's a blood vessel that runs through it. And the only person that can take care of that is God. You see, if God don't heal that and make it heal back right, you'll always, that hand could be paralyzed, or you can have trouble with it, bad arthritis. And we went to the doctor, so we went back about a month later, no change. Went back about a month later, no change. Went back about a month later, no change. Then I think Vicki got a prayer cloth and put in this little cast. We went back the next time. and the doctor said, completely healed, looking perfect. And so, but anyway, that stopped Nathaniel from going on his little adventure. And then later he told me what all was involved, and he said, I was stupid. I said, well, I told you God was going to stop you. And I said, if you just keep going, then it's going to get worse. But it wasn't long after that, him and Andy started talking, and he said, I don't know, he said, Andy, get hurt talking about maybe being boyfriend, girlfriend, what do you think? I said, well, I don't, because I was trying to get him away from this other city. And I said, well, it looks like to me God closed one door and opened another. Said, so, you know.
Yeah.
So anyway, this is where we at. So only time will tell if God, I would say this, and I'll shut up. Every time in my life, I can look back, I would say every time, but most times, if there's a major change in my life, God gives me a little bit of a glimpse into the future. And if he don't, this, by the time it happens, he'll come to me and say, it's going to be okay, and this is what's going to happen. So I really think God just gave me a little glimpse into the future. So here we are, and it's up to them now.
That's right. Thank you for saying that. Hey, y'all listen to that. Yeah, that's true. Those little moments, don't ignore those moments. God leads us. Isn't that something? That's all. He can only share that today.
Yeah. I had no idea.
That's perfect.
Well, man, just be careful in what you decide to do in life, because God will just break your bones.
He'll put the roadblocks there.
You got nine more.
I remember that time.
It worked fine, though.
It's so good to be standing on this side of things, knowing and seeing, knowing what God's going to do. That's just wonderful.
Your eyes, I lose all track of time when I get lost inside them, like the ocean deep I dive in. And your smile, I can't.
Oh, I thought about that many a day. I gauge because I'm 57 now.
And you know, you married me and Clyde, and you married Justin and Diana, and
Stacey. It's a family affair. I'm glad you told me that. Now, isn't that something?
Yeah. Wow.
I'm glad you told me that.
Remember, I was 50 when I got married. That's what all I've been through since I got married. Too old for all that.
No, he was kind of nervous.
If I was, I'd stop the clocks, and then I'd lock that door behind us, and I would hold you close, never let. Never be enough. I want forever for us. Your home, I could search the whole of space and never find that warm embrace I feel when we are face to face. And my love, you stole my heart in a midnight. And then you lock me up in paradise. And baby, nothing's ever felt so right. But a day turns to an hour, turns to a minute, and the moment's gone. And how I wish that I was Father Time. If I was, I'd stop the clocks, and then I'd lock that door behind. I would hold you close, never let go. Oh, a million years would never be enough. I want forever for us. So say you.